नमस्कार आप सब, सुप्रभात। आपका आयुष दर्पण जर्नल के प्लेटफॉर्म पे हमारे साथ मुंबई से जुड़ते हैं डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी। डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी जो हैं वो आयुर्वेद में शल्य चिकित्सा के एक विशेषज्ञ हैं, और वो अमर आयुर्वेद .com के नाम से उनकी एक होम पेज भी है। वो उनका प्रोफाइल, उन्होंने महाराष्ट्र यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हेल्थ साइंस नासिक से उन्होंने अपना ग्रेजुएशन किया है, और आर्य पोद्दार गवर्नमेंट आयुर्वेदिक कॉलेज मुंबई से वे MS और PhD हैं। बहुत बहुत सारे उन्होंने काम किए हैं। वर्तमान में वो स्कूल ऑफ आयुर्वेदा DY पाटिल यूनिवर्सिटी में वाइस प्रिंसिपल और एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट के पोस्ट पे हैं। ये नवी मुंबई में स्थित कॉलेज है, जो बड़ा ही फेमस कॉलेज है। इसके अलावा वो कंसल्टिंग एनोरेक्टल सर्जन भी हैं, जो पाइल्स, फिशर, फिस्टुला, क्षार सूत्र ये सब वो करते हैं, और 15 सालों से इस विधा की प्रैक्टिस कर रहे हैं। इसके अलावा वो श्री साई हॉस्पिटल कैस्टल मिल नाका थाने से जुड़े हैं, गुरु कृपा हॉस्पिटल ST वर्कशॉप थाने से जुड़े हैं। उनका एकेडमिक प्रोफेशनल पार्टिसिपेशन आप देखें तो वो मेंबर बहुत सारी संस्थाओं के काउंसिल मेंबर हैं। वो PG टीचिंग के रूप में भी उनका एक्सपीरियंस रहा है, PhD गाइड भी रहे हैं वो, UG और PG के एग्जामिनर भी हैं कई बार रहे हैं, और कई सारी किताबें भी पब्लिश करने का उनको एक रिकॉग्निशन मिलता है। उन्होंने कई सारी किताबें भी लिखी है, उन्होंने कई सारे कोर्सेज भी कराए हैं। साथ साथ वो EDR क्षार सूत्र किट, जो एक एडवांस क्षार सूत्र कैरियर कम एप्लीकेशन डिवाइस है, जिसको पेटेंट फाइल किया गया IPL गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के द्वारा, वो उसके इन्वेंटर हैं। अग्निकर्म डिवाइस को उन्होंने एक यूनिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट, जो थर्मल बर्न थेरेपी के रूप में, उन्होंने अग्निकर्म डिवाइस को जो है वो इनोवेट किया है, मॉडिफाई किया है। बहुत सारे अवार्ड्स अचीवमेंट्स मिले हैं उन्हें, जिनमें अर्क साइन इंटरनेशनल अवार्ड, एक्सीलेंस अवार्ड, इंटरनेशनल सुश्रुत अवार्ड, धनवंतरी अवार्ड, तथागत इंटरनेशनल एक्सीलेंस अवार्ड, पैनेसिया इंटरनेशनल एक्सीलेंस अवार्ड, थाने गुंजन अवार्ड, बेस्ट टीचिंग मॉड्यूल अवार्ड, फर्स्ट प्राइज फॉर बेस्ट साइंटिफिक रिसर्च पेपर अवार्ड, और बेस्ट ओरल प्रेजेंटेशन के कई अवार्ड्स, बैट वैद्य पटवर्धन मेमोरियल सुश्रुत पुरस्कार, ऐसे बहुत सारे उनको अवार्ड्स मिले हैं। तो ऐसे बहुत सारे एक्टिविटीज़ में रहते हैं। कई नेशनल कन्वेनर हैं, वो असिस्टेंट सेक्रेटरी हैं आयुर्वेद महासम्मेलन के, चेयरमैन नीमा स्टूडेंट फॉरम के, सब ये सब बहुत सारे एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज़ में रहते हैं। तो मैं ऐसे अगर इनके पूरे प्रोफाइल को पढ़ने जाऊँ तो लगता है 1 घंटे का समय शायद मुझे इसी के लिए देना पड़े। तो ऐसे डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी जी का हम इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर स्वागत करते हैं, और वो आपको आज जो उनका एक प्रेजेंटेशन है, जो कि डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी जी को मैं जानता हूँ, मैं इनके कॉलेज में गया था और मैंने वहाँ बर्म चिकित्सा का एक वर्कशॉप किया था। तो आज जो हमारे प्लेटफॉर्म पे, आयुष दर्पण जर्नल के प्लेटफॉर्म पे, डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी हीट बर्न थेरेपी इन आयुर्वेद, यानी अग्निकर्म के बारे में। देखिए, आयुर्वेद में जो एक बहुत बड़ी चीज़ जो लोग बात करते हैं कि पेन मैनेजमेंट नहीं है और दर्द को ठीक नहीं किया जा सकता, लेकिन हमने अपने इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर ऐसे स्पेशलाइज्ड डॉक्टर्स को लेके आए हैं जिन्होंने ये बताया है। देखिए, आप लोग स्टूडेंट्स हैं, डॉक्टर्स हैं, अलग अलग स्पेशलिटीज़ के लोग हैं, आपको आपका आपका इस विधा पर विश्वास बढ़े, इसीलिए हम ये प्रोग्राम्स ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं, और हम डिफरेंट स्पेशलिटीज़ को हम अपने इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर लेके आते हैं, और ताकि वो आपको, आपकी कॉन्फिडेंस को, आपकी पैथी पर, आपके विश्वास को और बढ़ा सकें। तो ऐसे ही डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी आज आपको अग्निकर्म के बारे में, हीट बर्न के बारे में एक अपना प्रैक्टिकल प्रेजेंटेशन देंगे, क्योंकि आप जैसा आपने अभी सुना मेरे द्वारा, वो बहुत सारे उन्होंने काम किए हैं। तो डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी सर,
नमस्ते डॉक्टर
हेलो,
नवीन जोशी जी, एम आई ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल टू यू ऑल? हेलो डॉक्टर जोशी, हेलो हेलो Am I audible, sir?
डॉक्टर
डॉक्टर
अमर
टू
द्विवेदी सर, आपको मेरी आवाज आ रही है?
जी सर, नाउ इट इज क्लियर. एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल? मेरी आवाज आ रही है सर?
आ रहे अमर, आ रहे, शुरू हो जाओ.
ओके सर, थैंक यू सो मच. डॉक्टर आवाड सर, आई कुड रिकॉग्नाइज योर नेम एंड हेलो एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, द डेलीगेट्स हु
मेरी
आर
आवाज आई एम हेलो. नेटवर्क में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है. डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी सर, आपको मेरी आवाज आ
जी
रही है?
सर. जी सर, आवाज आ रही है.
सर आप अपना प्रेजेंटेशन स्टार्ट करिए, बीच में नेटवर्क. जी हम फेसबुक पे लाइव है सर, आप अपना प्रेजेंटेशन स्टार्ट करिए सर. बीच में नेटवर्क की कुछ प्रॉब्लम आई थी, हम दोबारा से आ गए हैं सर, और आपका मैंने परिचय दे दिया है, और मैं अब आपको आपके प्रेजेंटेशन के लिए आपको आमंत्रित करता हूँ, और आप सर अपना प्रेजेंटेशन स्टार्ट करें. यदि बीच में कोई नेटवर्क का इशू भी आता है तो उसको हम सॉल्व करेंगे, और उसको हम दोबारा से भी करेंगे, लेकिन आप अपना प्रेजेंटेशन स्टार्ट करिए सर. थैंक यू सर.
Namaste and a very warm welcome to all the participants who are attending this webinar today. I am thankful to Dr. Naveen Joshi ji for inviting me and giving me this wonderful opportunity on his very esteemed web portal Ayush Darpan. And friends, today we are going to have a talk on Agni Karma Chikitsa. We all are well aware about this parasurgical procedure in Ayurveda. It is also called as Anushalya Karma. And all these parasurgical procedures such as Agni Karma, Kshar Sutra and Rakta Mokshan, the bloodletting therapy, these are the wonderful treatment modalities, and they are in fact known as minimally invasive technique or non-surgical interventions in Ayurveda, and they are very effective and they are very much known and famous for their instant therapeutic results. That is why we are going to discuss on one of the very unique parasurgical procedure, that is Agni Karma Chikitsa today. And as Dr. Joshi rightly said, nowadays pan India, I mean, this Agni Karma Chikitsa is very much promoted and practiced as a best modality for pain management. So that is why we have taken this opportunity to explore and focus on this wonderful treatment known as Agni Karma Chikitsa. So let us start with the today's talk. And in the beginning, we should know about the introduction, the background part of this wonderful treatment. So we will start with the definition part. Well, the definition in Ayurveda about Agni Karma, it is quoted as Agnina Kritva Yat Karma, Agni Sambandhi Va Yat Karma Tad Agni Karma. Meaning is, in Ayurveda, treatment with heat burn is called Agni Karma Chikitsa. In modern terminology, we can name it as heat burn therapy or therapeutic heat burn, and a few people also name it as a thermal microcautery. All these are the synonym of Agni Karma, and which explains that there is a definite use of heat source for the treatment purpose, which is known as Agni Karma. Further, if we move to see the background of this wonderful treatment, the references about Agni Karma is found in right even the Vedic era. If I would say that even in Atharva Veda and Rig Veda, we find the references about Agni Karma. To mention a few here, in Rig Veda, it is mentioned as one of the modality for Krimi Chikitsa. Now here, Krimi Chikitsa, you are not supposed to consider it as a worm infestation and its management. Here, Krimi at larger scale, you can think about the various living microorganism, including bacteria, fungi, and even the viruses. So to kill these, Agni Karma is used. That is the reference in the Atharva Veda. The next reference in Atharva Veda, many places you will find that they have mentioned Agni as a bheshaj, means it is a type of medicine. That is the reference we get in Atharva Veda. Coming to Rig Veda, well, in Rig Veda, it is mentioned that Agni Karma in the form of Yajna Karma kills the various bacteria that causes the disease. Now, again, this is very interesting. If you see that how Agni Karma in the form of Yajna Karma can be practiced. So, I would just mention a few NGOs you might be knowing better, Agnihotra and this Gayatri Parivar. These are the people who are promoting and practicing Yajna Karma at home level and at small level during their ritual. And they say that though people who perform Yajna Karma at a smaller scale regularly in their home during their ritual and puja, while offering their prayers, those people are less prone to get disease. So they have done a lot of research on that, and the reference we found actually in the Rig Veda that they say that this Yajna Karma can kill bacteria. Coming directly to the Ayurvedic perspectives, now in Charak Samhita, where we get reference about Agni Karma, the first reference in Charak Samhita we get is Agni Karma is used as Strasan Chikitsa for the treatment of sannyas. Again, it is very interesting. Now here, sannyas, you are not supposed to consider the patient in comatose condition. Here you can just consider a patient who is coming, who is in unconscious level of stage, and maybe he is suffering from some convulsive disorder or some syncope sort of thing, and he is unconscious. In those patients, Agni Karma can be performed to retain or regain his consciousness. Now here again, the science, the logic is, when the patient is unconscious, you are supposed to do simulation. So Agni Karma, if it is done, the heat therapy, it work as a deep stimulus, and in this way the unconsciousness is cured and the patient gains the consciousness. So that is the first reference in Charak Samhita. Next reference is that Agni Karma is indicated in Mausa Gata Vyadhi. Now in Mausa Gata Vyadhi, it ranges from simple mastitis, that is inflammation in the muscle, to the myopathy. So in all various conditions where the disease is actually situated in the muscular level or the Mausa Gata, in those cases one can practice Agni Karma for therapeutic purpose. Next reference we get is we are directly coming to the Sushrut Samhita, which is the basic textbook of Shalya Tantra. So in Sushrut Sutra Sthan, Agni Karma is described as one of the equipment to be kept ready before the surgery. And this has been advocated in the chapter known as Agroparhani Adhyaya. Now, Agroparhani Adhyaya is nothing but the list of the equipment and instrument which is kept ready before any surgical procedure. So in that list, Sushrut advocate to keep Agni ready in the surrounding. Then next reference about Agni Karma is that we all know, we have discussed that Agni Karma is considered as one of the unique Anushalya. So it is one of the Anushalya also. Next reference, the very wonderful description about Agni Karma is given. I mean, Sushruta has dedicatedly written a complete chapter on Agni Karma Vidhi, and that is Sutra Sthan chapter 12, where Sushruta has elaborated it wonderfully. I would say that he has described the definition to the types, to the site where Agni Karma is to be done, the mode of action, the complications, the sign and symptom of adequate burn. All these things are wonderfully explained and compiled in this particular chapter, chapter 12 of Sutra Sthan. Next is Agni Karma is also included in the 60 Upakram. We all know that in Vrana Chikitsa, Sushruta has mentioned 60 different measures to treat inflammation and wound. So in that 60 procedure, one of the procedure is Agni Karma, and there it is used to treat non-healing ulcers. Now coming next to the most unique and most deliberate topic, that is Agni Karma is mentioned as a treatment modality for various Asthi Sandhi Snayu Gata Vata Prakop. This is the indication we see in Sushrut Samhita about the treatment with Agni Karma Chikitsa. So this is all about the introduction part, friends. We will first discuss about the conventional knowledge and information which we get in the textbook. Then we will go to the SOP level where we have formulated the exact procedure, and then we will also discuss about the innovations and the standardization of this wonderful treatment modality. So let us start with the materials used for Agni Karma. Now, once you know about what Agni Karma is, one should know which are the material by which modality you can perform Agni Karma. So in Sushruta Sanhita, depending upon the disease and its predominance, there are two factors of deciding the material. One is the disease, the nature of disease, about the and the predominance of desa. Based on this, Sushrut has mentioned various materials to be used for Agni Karma Chikitsa. For example, I would say if the disease is located superficially at the skin level, if the Twakadagdha is required, there he has mentioned Pippali, Ajashtakrut, Godanta, Sharasalaka sort of thing. Then for the Mausadagdha, he has mentioned metal-made probes. Then for the Sira, Snayu, Sandhi, Asthi sort of thing, he has mentioned to perform Agni Karma with the help of Taila, Vasa, I mean hot oil or Ghrita or honey or Jaggery, those sort of thing. If you think it, you will come to know that these materials actually generate different amount of temperatures. So that is why, as per the required, as per the depth of the disease, Sushruta has described various materials to be used for Agni Karma. I will summarize it as all these materials are not feasible to get. So you can actually categorize the disease in two categories. The category one is where the disease is of catabolic nature, or in Ayurveda, you can say the dhatu kshaya janya conditions, where there is a disease due to various degenerative procedures. So in those cases, one can use metal probe made up of gold or silver. The other category is the anabolic condition or margavarodha janya condition or the hypergrowth conditions. In those cases, you can use a metal probe made up of either lauha or panchadhatu, iron or panchadhatu probes. So this is how, this is my experience. You can categorize the disease and select the various probes. Now, as we have discussed that these materials generate different amount of heat or the temperature, so there are certain researches on it, like which says that when the metal probe is made, tip of the metal probe is made red hot, at that particular time, gold liberates around 62 to 65 degrees centigrade, silver liberate around 350 degrees centigrade, which is the maximum. Then copper liberates around 212, iron 228, pippali around 55 to 58, ajashakrut around 45 to 55. These are the ranges, the amount of heat or the temperature generated by these probes when they are made red hot. After knowing the different materials and the amount of heat they generate, we should know about the various types of Agni Karma. Now, here, first we will discuss the types based on the shape of Agni Karma. Means once the Agni Karma is performed, there will be a definite marking on that particular patient or that particular lesion. So, based on the shape of those particular Agni Karma, the Agni Karma is divided into 7 types. I will just share one slide to explain this. Just wait for a second, sir. Dr. Joshi, can I share the screen? Hello? Dr. Joshi, I'm not able to share the screen. Hello? Dr. Joshi? Anyway, there is some technical issue. That slide is not, I'm not able to share that screen.
जी अमर जी, क्या हुआ सर?
सर, आई एम नॉट एबल टू शेयर माय फोटो.
वन मिनट सर, वन मिनट, आई विल गिव यू द ऑप्शन. लीजिए ऑप्शन, आपको शेयर स्क्रीन दिख नहीं रहा है सर?
हाँ, वो उन्होंने बोला है कि होस्ट हैज डिसेबल्ड द स्क्रीन शेयरिंग।
1 मिनट
होस्ट
सर, वो मैं करता हूँ सर, 1 मिनट। पार्टिसिपेंट, शेयर स्क्रीन। अब देखिए सर, आपके पास आया ऑप्शन।
जी सर, यस, इट इज डन, इट इज रिजॉल्व, थैंक यू वेरी मच सर।
पहले
सो हियर ऑन योर स्क्रीन यू कैन सी द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ अग्निकर्मा अकॉर्डिंग टू डिफरेंट शेप्स, एंड सुश्रुता हैज डिस्क्राइब्ड
सर,
फोर
योर
बेसिक
कैमरा
शेप्स।
कैमरा सर सर प्लीज ऑन योर कैमरा, योर वीडियो इज नॉट कमिंग। या ओके, नाउ ओके।
Sorry. So Sushruta has described basic four shapes based on the sign, the postman markings, that is Vilay, Bindu, Vilak, Vilekha, Pratisaran, and then Sushruta and Vaghbhata has added three more types to it, and that is Ardhachandra, Swastik, and Ashtapad. These are the actual markings which is left behind after the Agni Karma. Valay is the round shape. Bindu is a dot sort of Agni Karma. Vilekha is a plain line. Then Pratisaran, multiple lines. Ardhachandra is semilunar or semicircular shape. Swastik, we all know, Ashtapad is having 8 limbs. So these are the various types of Agni Karma described in the text. Moving further to very interesting part now, and that is about knowing the site of Agni Karma. This is again very interesting. So, can you see this screen now?
ओके सर, ओके।
So Sushrut has mentioned various locations or the sites where the heat burn is to be done. We are discussing now whatever is mentioned in the text, and thereafter we will discuss the applied part also. So in the first reference, in Shirorog, now mentioning Shirorog, you have to consider all the conditions, painful conditions in the neck and the head region. In that it comes, we are covering here the headache, the various migraine, even the adhimantha. So all in all those painful conditions, one should do Agni Karma between the two eyebrow and frontal and temporal area. That is the place mentioned for performing Agni Karma in Shirorog. Moving further to diseases of eyelids, here Agni Karma is to be done at the roots of eyelashes. Here, particular disease mentioned is entropion, and we all know that there is ingrowing of the eyelashes, which actually irritates the sclera and conjunctiva, and patient is uncomfortable because of that, is having severe pricking pain. So in that case, even nowadays, the people are either plucking up the eyelashes, or they are doing burning these roots of eyelashes with the help of laser. So same treatment modality was mentioned in Ayurvedic text also. Moving further to the painful conditions and Vata's disease, this is very interesting. I have mentioned few conditions like heel pain, known as Parsknee-Shool, or the plantar fasciitis and calcaneal spur, then Sandhigata Vata, Aam Vata, frozen shoulder, sciatica, spondylosis, lumbago, all these painful conditions having origin in the bone and muscular region, musculoskeletal pains. In those cases, one should perform Agnikarma at the site of maximum pain. Now, when I say at the site of maximum pain, you can understand the place of heat burn either by asking to the patient, that is known as subjective way of knowing where the pain is. Patient will tell you this is the place where he is suffering more pain or feeling more pain. The other way is you can simply palpate and see where the deep tenderness is. That point you have to fix and mark and perform Agnikarma. Thereafter, very distinct and very controversial reference about Agnikarma we can see, and that is in incomplete hernia or the antraj vriddhi, Sushruta has mentioned to perform Agnikarma. Now again, when I say this, as we all know that antraj vriddhi is a clear surgical condition, so in that case, how this Agnikarma will work? Now again, while pursuing my post-graduation, I have discussed with my guide, Dr. Venkatesh Joshi ji, and even few experts who are performing Agnikarma, and we have come to a conclusion that there is a definite role of Agnikarma in incomplete hernia, where hernia is not protruded into the scrotum. If it is up to the level of superficial ring, means the early stage of herniation, in that case we can definitely perform Agnikarma. And where one should perform, he has given two places. One is actually at the level of superficial inguinal ring in the Vangshan prant. So from the place the hernia starts from the deep inguinal ring, and from the through the anal canal it comes up to the superficial ring. So in that case, if we perform Agnikarma at the superficial ring with this specially designed probe of spoon shape, chammach ke aakar ka spoon shaped instrument or the metal probe, if we perform Agnikarma at the site of superficial ring, there will be definite post burn fibrosis, and there will be obliteration of inguinal canal at that level, which actually prevent the content of abdomen to reach to scrotum. So that is the level or the logic by those the wisdom of those ancient maharshis. The other place for doing performing Agnikarma in inguinal hernia is viparita padangushtha, which means one should perform Agnikarma on the first or the greater toe of leg of opposite side of the body. Now this is very interesting. If the hernia is on the right side, you have to perform Agnikarma on the greater toe of the left leg. Why this is so? Again, there is a hypothesis that all these sensory information crosses at the level of medulla. So if we perform Agnikarma on the left side, it will affect the right side. And if we, for when in the next slide we will see the effect of Agnikarma, there we have mentioned that this Agnikarma actually increase the efficiency of muscle and increase the muscular tone. So this will help in pacifying the shutter like action at the level of deep inguinal ring, and in this way the hernia can be prevented. So that was the reference which requires further research to actually validate the quote made in Sushruta Samhita, that treatment of incomplete hernia is to be done with the help of Agnikarma. Moving further, post surgery, I mean, once you are performing or excising cyst, mass, warts, tumor, piles, fistula, in all this condition, it is advocated to perform Agnikarma in the post-surgery bed of the ulcer to avoid recurrence. That is very interesting. And so here you have to do Agnikarma after excision at the bed of the wound. And in the bleeding disorder, if the vessels are bleeding, we have to hold or catch the bleeders with the help of hemostatic forceps and perform Agnikarma at the tip. And this is very much done by the cautery machine nowadays. So this is all about the site of Agnikarma mentioned in Ayurvedic text. Moving further to know the effect of Agnikarma. Now this is again very interesting. when we discuss about the effect of Agni Karma, first we will discuss about the effect as per the Ayurvedic theories. And once we complete the Ayurvedic part, we will go ahead with the modern approach of
sir, slide slow stop ho gaya sir.
Sir, dikha raha. Is it there? Now is it on screen?
Yes, theek hai.
Yeah.
Ji aa gaya.
Actually, I have to find few images and then put into the sharing mode. So that is why it is taking little time. I'm really regretting for this, for the inconvenience of you all. Moving further to know the effect of Agni Karma, first we will discuss the Ayurvedic perspective. Now, as Dr. Joshi has already said that this is very much known for its pain management. So how this happens, there is a theory or hypothesis for that. We all know that Agni Karma is having Ushna Gun, or it has the hot property. Whereas all the painful condition or in the condition where there is a vishesan of vata and as adjuvant kapha also, in all these cases there will be a definite pain. There is a famous quote also that nasti vata drute ruja, means in every condition of vata prakop or vishesan of vata there will be a definite pain in the system. So this Agni Karma having ushna property is against the quality of vata dosha, and in this way once we are performing Agni Karma, it will definitely pacify and reduce the vata and vitiated kapha also. And once vata is pacified, pain will be nullified or minimized. This is the way it works on pain management as per Ayurvedic perspective. Next is again very interesting. Just I will take 1 second to take to the next slide. Now here in this slide, the next slide which we are going to see is all about the samprapti vighatan, means regression of pathogenesis. This is very interesting and my choice of topic, because I actually deny that this Agni Karma is only useful in the pain management. I in fact quote here witnessing you all that Agni Karma is a full-fledged independent treatment modality. It's a complete holistic treatment which actually reverses the pathophysiology of the condition. It performs the samprapti vighatan and the disease is cured, and that we see practically also, because once we do repeated Agni Karma in a particular patient, the complete patient is completely cured. So to explain that particular phenomenon, here we have put forward the second theory, and this is also as per Ayurvedic basic principles, that Agni Karma, as we have discussed earlier, it has got Ushna Guna or hot property, and once we deliver certain amount of heat, it definitely increase the Dhatu Agni. Now when I say Dhatu Agni, we all know that in all the pathogenesis there is a definite role of Mandagni. Now this Mandagni can be at the level of systemic, known as Jatharagni Mandya, which requires systemic treatment, and at the same time there will be a definite Dhatu Agni Mandya also at the local level where the tissue fire is decreased. In that case, once you perform Agni Karma, there will be a definite amount of heat delivered at that particular site, which actually cures the condition. That is, the Manda Dhatu Agni gets pacified, it comes to balance, it comes to equilibrium, and in this way it enhances nourishment and formation of good newer tissue. At the same time, it also performs ama pachan. This is again a very important concept of Ayurveda, that for all the disease for permanent cure you should focus on ama pachan. So this performs ama pachan and removal of accumulated toxins or unwanted metabolites at that particular site, and in this way it performs the samprapti vighatan, or in modern terms we can say it reverses the pathogenesis. So this is how you will have to explain about the mode of action of Agni Karma in treatment part. Moving further to the modern perspective, I'll again take a few seconds. Please pardon. Well, I will have two slides now.
Sir, आप वीडियो हो गया है. हाँ, yes, correct.
For modern modern perspective, again we will have two theory here. The first theory is about treatment in degenerative conditions, especially for the musculoskeletal conditions, where they say that Agni Karma stimulates the piezoelectricity of bone. This releases electrical signals and this causes oriental deposit in the lesion. So wherever there is a calcium or phosphorus deficiency, that oriental deposition will take place in that particular site, which resists the deformity, prevent the further damage, and ultimately restores the normal function of the condition. This is how you can explain about the mode of action of Agni Karma in various degenerative conditions like spondylosis, osteoarthritis, plantar fasciitis sort of thing, which says that Agni Karma has local action. It is capable to break down the vicious adhesions and encapsulations, and thus it also relieves pain also. Moving further to the next theory of Agni Karma, we are discussing about the modern perspective, and this is all about the systemic action of Agni Karma. This is very interesting, and this is based on various researchers worldwide, and they have actually evaluated the role of heat burn on systemic level. If you see this slide, I will simplify this slide. As if we perform Agni Karma, there is an effect on circulatory system, neurohormonal level, lymphatic system. So at circulatory level, if we talk about, my point is albumin, glucose, fats, amino acids, lymphocyte ratio is increased. Antibody antigen phenomena is activated. Local energy level are activated. Bring back the joint inflammation to normalcy. This is how it works through the circulatory level. If we talk about the neurohormonal level, tryptophan releases the serotonin and melatonin, which are capable of reducing edema and inflammation. If we talk about the lymphatic system, lymph circulation increases. It releases diamine oxidase, which breaks down the histamine, and thus inflammation is stop. So that is the effect of Agni Karma at this systemic level. There were a lot of researches done to validate the effect of Agni Karma. There is Dr. Ben Haaf. I would quote his published abstract and his findings on effect of Agni Karma at the systemic level. First, he has mentioned that effect on metabolism. Well, the local tissue metabolism is improved, what his research says. Then on the effect of circulation, he says that Agni Karma decreases the viscosity of blood and local sensory nerves get stimulated, which result in increase in the blood circulation. So the first finding is that it improves the metabolism. Second finding of his research is that it improves the blood circulation. Third, on effect, it is known to all us that due to increase in the local metabolism, the accumulated waste products and toxins are excreted, which normalizes the circulation and releases pressure on end nerve. This is very important, because pain is because there is a pressure on the end nerve. So that end nerve pressure is released, and thus it results in reducing the pain factor. And further on the effect of muscle, Dr. Weinhoff says that rise in temperature induces relaxation of muscle. So it performs relaxation of muscle, and also it increases in the efficiency of their action. So this is all about the mode of action of Agni Karma. We will move further we will move further to the SOP, that is how you have to perform Agni Karma. So as Agni Karma is a treatment modality or the parasurgical procedure, we have to divide the SOP as per Trivid Karma concept, and that is we should know about the Purva Karma, that is pre-operative procedure, then main procedure, that is Pradhan Karma, and the post-operative care. So we will categorize accordingly. So we will start and discuss first about the Purva Karma. Well, I always say to my students and the researchers that before performing Agni Karma, it is mandatory to take written consent. This part is very important. Once you have decided that this patient requires Agni Karma, first you have to explain the patient about your treatment modality, that you are going to give a desired amount of heat, you are going to burn that patient, and you have to convince the patient, you have to explain about the mode of action, the desired outcome, and even the complication part. So once everything is explained, you have to take informed written consent. That is the first point in SOP of pre-operative procedure. Next is, if it is an elective procedure, you have to always go for a basic blood investigation such as CBC and blood sugar. These two are the minimum requirement, because you should know if the patient is very much anemic, and if patient is having some sugar, raised sugar level, in those cases you have to have more precautions. So you have to get the blood CBC and the blood sugar level done. Then next is the confirmation of site. As we have already discussed, that you have to find the exact place where you are going to perform Agni Karma. That is, this process is known as confirmation of site. Counseling, we have already discussed. And then the next part is, before directly performing Agni Karma, you have to clean that area. Now here, it is very important that generally in surgery, if we ask our resident to clean the area, cleaning and dripping is the part of pre-operative procedure. So they usually take either Cevalon or Betadine or spirit, the alcohol-based spirit, for cleaning that area. Now here, it is all contraindicated. So if you are performing Agni Karma and you want to clean the area, you are supposed to clean it with either a normal water, tap water, or the normal saline. But never use spirit-based sanitizers or the disinfectant for cleaning the area. So this is all about the pre-operative measures. Coming directly to the main procedure now. Now, for main procedure, I'll again share a slide to you. Just give me a second, friends. This will actually help to understand the actual procedure. Just a second. Here comes the main procedure. Well, if we talk about India, there are two different disciples who are performing or practicing Agni Karma. First, we will discuss about the conventional method, which is described in Shushrut Sanhita. On your slide, on your left side, you can see that there is a hot red silver probe, and the knee area is getting exposed and burning or heat treatment is given. So this is the conventional way. I have named it as Samyak Dagdha Vrana Agni Karma. Samyak Dagdha Vrana Agni Karma. Please get it very clear that when Sushruta says Agni Karma, he has given the sign and symptom of adequate heat burn, that is Samyak Dagdha. So he desire or he advocate actually doing Agni Karma by Samyak Dagdha Vrana. So that is type 1, which we can say intermittent multiple heat burn are given. Type 2 is again limited to certain areas of Maharashtra. I would name the inventor for this procedure our legendary Ayurveda Agnikarma expert Dr. Gowte from Pune, he has developed or innovated this technique. His concept was like the first or the conventional method, there was a scar formation and it was little more painful. So to tackle this and to get the equal effect, he has developed his own way of delivering Agnikarma, in which he has taken a small metal probe. The tip of the probe is placed at the site where Agnikarma is desired. And on the other side, he has continuously kept a heat source or the fire or the flame. And this flame indirectly transfers certain amount of heat to the site where the tip is placed. And after, say, 3 to 5 minutes, there will be around 55 to 60 degree of temperature delivered at that particular site indirectly. And patient when say that he is feeling warmth or burning sensation, that means the treatment is complete. And this can also be objectively seen. You will see the redness in that area where the tip is in contact with the skin. So this is the other way. For this, I have named as Dagdha Vrana Rahit Agni Karma. Dagdha Vrana Rahit Agni Karma. The first or the conventional way was Samyak Dagdha Vrana Agni Karma. And the modified technique is called Dagdha Vrana Rahit Agni Karma. In the second type, there is no burn marks or post-burn markings are absent. So that is the beauty of the innovation here. So these are the two basic procedures. We will discuss about further innovations also in the later part of the presentation. After discussing the main procedures, we all know that in the first type, you make the tip of the probe red hot, and then you give multiple burns at that surrounding and peripheral area of the diseased area. And in the other way, you are performing Agnikarma indirectly, which is a continuous heating method, and certain amount of heat is delivered. So these are the two main procedures. Coming back to the post-operative, post-Agnikarma measures to be taken. So as we all know that after Agnikarma, there will be definite dah or the burning sensation or little bit of discomfort and mild pain due to Agnikarma. See, pain because of the disease is different, and pain due to performing Agnikarma, either by either way, there will be definite amount of burning sensation or dah at that particular site. So you have to take care of that. So for that, practically what we are using, we are applying Shatadhauta Ghrit, Yashti Madhu Ghrit, or plain Ghrit. Anything you can use. The Yashti Madhu Siddha Ghrit is one of the best thing which gives immediate relief from burning sensation and pain due to Agnikarma, and also it helps in promoting healing of the scar. So in type one type of Agnikarma, that is Samyak Dagdha Vrana Agnikarma, there will be definite post-burn marking or the burn marks or the vrana. So to take care of that, Yashti Madhu Siddha Ghrita is one of the best local treatment you can give immediately after the procedure, or you can use Shatadhauta Ghrit, or plain Ghrita also can be locally, topically applied, or you can use even the Majja of Kumari, which gives the sense of cooling. So anything you can use, or if it is not, you are not allergic to the modern, you can use the silver nitrate cream as well, which is Sofradex or some whatever is available. So soframycin also can be locally applied. So this is about the post-operative measures to be taken. And then one more important thing is you have to educate the patient that he will suffer from little bit of discomfort or pain sort of thing because of this procedure. As we find, even after the best of the surgery, even if you perform laparoscopic surgery, there will be definite post-operative pain. So same way, you have to make the patient understand that because of Agnikarma, he will definitely have certain amount of discomfort or burning sensation or pain at the site where Agnikarma is done, and that is temporary, and that can be taken care of this by this local acclimation of Yasti Madhu Ghruta, and you can give Trifala Guggul orally, or Dashamul Ghanavati can be given to counter this sort of discomfort and pain. Even the Ashwagandha can be given, Dashamul can be given, Dashamula Rishta can be offered. And most important, one point left is, you have to educate the patient that he should not contaminate that area with water immediately after the procedure. So after Agnikarma, ideally we do normal bandaging, the cotton bandaging, so that that part will not be in contact with water for 1 or 2 days. So this is I think all about the post-operative care in the Agnikarma Chikitsa. Moving further to the how you will come to know that this Agnikarma is performed perfectly or it is the ideal way to perform Agnikarma. Sushruta has mentioned signs of adequate heat burn. Again, this is regarding the type 1, that is Samyak Dagdha Vrana Agnikarma. Sushruta says that the adequate signs are Laghvam, Vedana Shanti, and Vyadhi Vega Parikshaya. These are the 3 major symptoms by which you will come to know that you have performed the Agnikarma adequately. Laghvam means patient after Agnikarma will feel lightness, or the affected part gets lighter after Agnikarma. Then Vedana Shanti, we all know that pain will be reduced. And most important is Vyadhi Vega Parikshaya, means the progress of the disease is stopped. I mean, it helps in reversing the pathogenesis. So that which is seen in the repeated after the completion of the treatment. So this is about the signs and symptom of adequate heat burn. So if you read that chapter 12 of Sushruta Sutrasthan Agnikarma Vidhi, Sushruta has gone very at the very microscopic level, that he has given different sign and symptoms based on the area where you perform the Agnikarma. For example, for Tvaka Dagdha, you will find that there will be contraction of skin, crackling sounds, and bad odor. There will be bad smell after Agnikarma. If you perform Agnikarma targeting Mausa Dagdha, there will be pigeon color of the muscle, then the skin will be discolored and shriveled. Then for Sirasnayu Dagdha, there will be black discoloration, and most important, when Sira is concerned, there will be a bleeding, so that bleeding gets stopped or arrested because of Agnikarma. Then in Asthi Sandhigata Dagdha, there will be dryness, redness, hardness, and stricture formation. So see the beauty of knowledge of those ancient Maharshis, that they have gone at very microscopic level to make understand how the pathogenesis takes place and how we cure that ailment. And then finally coming to the supremacy of Agnikarma, this is very important, because what why we are exploring Agnikarma today among all those parasurgical procedure, because it is superior, considered superior among the Anushalya, because the quote given is tad dagdhanam roganam apunarbhavat bheshaj shastra kshareihi asadhyanam tat sadhyatvach. The meaning is tad dagdhanam roganam apunarbhavat. As I said, once the treatment or the Agnikarma is given, it is a non-recurrent treatment. Try to understand. If the Agnikarma is perfectly done at the desired periods, and you will not suffer from that particular disease again. So, tad dagdhanam roganam apunarbhavat. Next line is more important. Bheshaja shastra kshareihi asadhyanam. means if the condition is not treated by Bheshas, that is the palliative medicine, not treated by Shastrakarma, not treated by Sharakarma, all these cases which are incurable with the other parasurgical procedure can even be treated with Agnikarma. So that is the beauty of Agnikarma. Moving to the last part of today's talk, we have discussed that we will also going to have a little discussion on the various standardization and innovations of in the field of Agnikarma. As Dr. Gaurang Joshi has also said that I had a patent and I have innovated one instrument for Agnikarma. I would just share that work. That work you can Google, and the title of the research is Modified Agnikarma Device. Modified Agnikarma Device, a breakthrough in the standardization of Agnikarma therapy. This was my review article, the research article in which I have explained my instrument innovations and how it works in the treatment part. That has been elaborately discussed in this particular article. This work was published in a peer review journal known as IJRAP, International Journal of Research in Ayurveda and Pharma, which is publishing since the last 10 years. And in that article, I have explained about my innovation. When we talk in terms of innovation, we all know that there is a similar treatment known as Vidha Karma. Agni Karma, we have discussed, it is heat burn therapy. Vidha Karma actually meaning puncturing. So the word was actually used in context with Rakta Mokshan, where Sira Vedhan was done. So that is the Vedhan Karma or the puncturing. So few people also practice Vedhan Karma and they also get the equal result as that of Agnikarma. Then there is a new concept known as Vidhagni. You must have heard this word Vidhagni. This was innovated by one of my friend, Dr. Uday Kulkarni Jui, who is in Mumbai, and he has developed this synchronized way of getting accumulated benefit of Agni Karma and Vidha Karma together, in which what he does is he pricks the site with the fine needle of 28 gauge, and then he attaches the electric instrument to it, and then he delivers certain amount of heat to that particular site. So that is how the effect is achieved, which is a very wonderful treatment, especially for pain management. So this is Vidhagni. We have discussed about Vidha Karma, which is basically a type of Rakta Mokshan only, where the pricking is done with the help of a needle or the puncturing is done. Then coming to my innovations, I'll take a few seconds again to share my instrument image. We are on the last part of presentation now. Now, on your screen, there are two different instruments. While innovating or preparing these modified Agnikarma tools, I would say, I have taken the both concept. That is the first way, that is where you require Samyak Dagdha Vrana Agnikarma. And the other is the respected Dr. Gokte sir's technique, where he is giving limited amount of heat burn by indirect method. So I have worked on both these concepts. One of my PG student has done research on this, and currently one of my PhD student, who is also faculty in my department, Dr. Vedika Bhoir, she is working on this instrument. And to be precise, this first type, I have not taken much effort. This is a simple cervical cautery or the dermatology cautery machine, which is readily available in all the instrument shop. You can directly go and ask for the cervical cautery machine or the dermatology cautery machine. In that, it is an electrical device. You have to put on, switch on the electricity, and then you can fix the temperature in the temperature controller part. And then once you start this machine, the tip of the hand, hand gun is having a loop at its end. So that loop will get red hot after few minutes once you start that instrument. So what I have done is, on that loop, I have coated a silver foil, a silver plate I have coated. I mean, I have replaced that loop with the help of silver probe. And once this instrument is kept on switch on mode, after some time, you will find that the probe made up of this silver, replaced by this silver, will get red hot. And with that, you can directly perform the Agni Karma in the conventional way. It is done 1 to 2 seconds at one site, and the desired Samyak Dagdha Vran can be achieved. That in this instrument, I didn't put much of my inputs. Whereas in the second type, it is very interesting. It is actually a temperature control unit. It is available in the electrical shop. You can ask for it. It comes around 2.5 to 3,000 rupees only. And in this temperature control unit, there is a display where actually the amount of heat which is delivered is displayed on that particular part. So in this, we fix the temperature to 55 degree, maximum up to 60 degree. And what we have modified in this is the probe part. The probe, if you will see, it has multiple pins or multiple rods at the tip, at the end of the handpiece. And this, once you put on or switch on or start this instrument and fix the temperature to say 65 degrees centigrade, at the every pin, you will have the same amount of heat. So this is a very innovative sort of instrument, and you have to mark the place where you want to deliver the Agni Karma, and you have to simply place this instrument for 8 seconds. For 8 seconds, and you will get the equal benefit of type 2, that is indirect heating method or Dagdha Vrana Rahit sort of Agni Karma, where you will not find any post-burn marking. So I think this is all about today's session, and I have tried to cover this.
Thank you, Dr. Amar.
I have tried to cover this topic.
Thank you, Dr. Amar Dwivedi. Very nice presentation and very informative presentation you have delivered. And there are some questions also. I want to give some questions and the comments, beautiful comments which I got in Facebook page at this session. Is live in the Facebook, Ayush Darpan Journals Facebook, and there are 40,000 viewers in overall this Ayush Darpan Journal and Ayush Darpan different pages. We have shared the links. So Silpa Varkar Palaskar is saying that very nice, elaborated the whole process of Agni Karma and its importance in Ayurveda. Namrata Kulshrestha, she is telling that very good explanation of Agni Karma. Tulsi Shrestha from Nepal, great occasion and great presentation. Dr. Vishnu Vaivani, all the best. Respected Sir, Gyanendra Sahapati is asking some question. If we use cautery machine, can different props like gold, silver, etc., as discussed, be used?
Yes, yes, I have told you the first type, which is the Samyak Dagdha Vrana. Where we have,
already explained by Dr. Amar Dwivedi, Srinivas Guzarwar. Srinivas Guzarwar, wonderful presentation, Dr. Raviraj Konkani. Namaste, sir. In Charak Chikitsa Sthana, Pliha Udar Roga treatment told Agni Karma, sir. What was the site of Agni Karma for this Roga?
See, I have not discussed
about the science, site of the Agni Karma.
See, for actually, it worked basically.
So
if
I
you are
I think that
basically, when you are deciding this site, one is the actual reference, the guidelines given in that particular section of Charak Samhita, and the other is, as I said, you have to ask about the site where the patient is having maximum pain. At that site, you can perform Agni Karma. Basically, in all those systemic diseases, Agni Karma works at the nervous level and the circulatory level. So, I cannot say the exact site which is mentioned for that particular disease, but definitely in all diseases, if the Shastrakar says that the Agni Karma works, you have to perform Agni Karma according to their advisory.
Ajay Kumar Sharma is also telling that your presentation is very nice. Munilal Maurya is from Rishikesh. He is asking that, could you please tell again about material used in catabolic disorder?
See, when I say catabolic disorder, it is a modern term. You can think about all the dhatu kshaya janya diseases. In all those cases, if you are using metal probe, you can either use silver or gold made probes.
So I hope that I have taken all the questions, and it's very nice presentation. A lot of comments are coming, and this lecture is already saved in the Facebook page. Anybody can watch this page by sharing the link on their profile, as well as you can run a watch party on your profile. So it's a very good presentation, a very practical presentation. I'm Dr. Naveen Joshi. Dr. Amar Dwivedi, sometimes you take a name of Dr. Gauranga Joshi. I just little bit confusion. I'm Dr. Naveen Joshi. Your presentation is very nice. And Menal, Darade, Rajni Verma, Anurag Ahirwar, Satinder Pal Singh, J.N. Nautiyal, Vijay Jadav Ji. Vijay Jadav Ji is a very keenly observing all the presentations. So I already given him a best viewer award, Ayush Darpan Journal. Actually, he is watching all the presentation, whatever coming in the Ayush Darpan Journal page. Mayur Amar Pavaskar. Yes, Mayurji, good morning. Jay Krishna Pandey. Also, I have to finish this presentation. Thank you. As the presentation is very smooth and everything is quite well in this time. So I'm thankful to Dr. Amar Dwivedi. With any of the new presentation, we will again come to this platform to share your experience to the audience. I use that from journalist audiences. As you know that many of our students as well as the doctors, so it is a very good platform to share your views, as well as we are taking some comments also from the audience. So aapka bahut bahut dhanyawad hamare sath judne ke liye, aur agar aapke zoom mein kuch log jude hain, agar unka koi prashn ho to aap chat box mein likh sakte hain, main dekh leta hu. चैट बॉक्स में कोई भी क्वेश्चंस नहीं है. कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन विष्णु भवानी जी कर रहे हैं. विष्णु भवानी जी, आपका भी बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. आपने हमारे सेशन को देखा, आप सभी का धन्यवाद. तो हम इसको अब यहीं पे हम एंड करते हैं. हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए आप सभी का धन्यवाद. आयुष दर्पण जर्नल को आप देखते रहें. आप इस पे, आप में भी अगर प्रतिभा है और आप में भी रिप्रेजेंटेशन की तकनीक है, तो आप हमारे, आपके लिए मंच खुला है, आप आ सकते हैं. बट आपका प्रेजेंटेशन प्रैक्टिकल होना चाहिए, जैसा कि डॉक्टर अमर द्विवेदी ने दिया. तो ये इस प्रकार की प्रेजेंटेशन आपको देखने चाहिए, सीखने चाहिए, और प्रायोगिक तौर पे आपको इसको अप्लाई करना चाहिए. तो आप सभी का धन्यवाद. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सो मच सर. थैंक यू वेरी मच.